back to Dixie. Take me back to dear old Dixie. That's the only little old place for little old me. Old times, they are not forgotten. Whooping slaves and selling cotton and waiting for the Robert E. Lee. It was never there on time. I'll go back to the Swanee, where pellagra makes you scrawny and the jasmine and the tear gas smell just fine. I really am a fixin' to go back where there's no mixin' down below that Mason-Dixon line. Oh, poll tax, how I love you, my dear old poll tax. Oh, won't you come with me to Alabama, back to the arms of my dear old mammy? Her cookin's lousy and her hands are clammy, but what the hell, it's home. Yes, for paradise, the Southland is my nominee. Just give me a ham hock and a grit of harmony. I wanna start relaxing down in Birmingham or Jackson. When we're having fun, why no one interferes. I wanna talk with Southern gentlemen and put my white sheet on again. I ain't seen one good lynching in years. The land of the boll weevil, where the laws are medieval, is calling me to come and nevermore roam. I wanna go back to the Southland, that y'all, and shut my mouthland. Be it ever so decadent, there's no place like home. The shades of night are falling, comes a fellow everyone knows. It's the old dope peddler, spreading joy wherever he goes. Every evening you will find him around our neighborhood. It's the old dope peddler, doing well by doing good. He gives the kids free samples because he knows full well that today's young innocent faces will be tomorrow's clientele. Here's a cure for all your troubles. Here's an end to all distress. It's the old dope peddler with his powdered happiness. Since I still appreciate you, let's find love while we may. Because I know I'll hate you when you are old and gray. So say you love me here and now, I'll make the most of that. Say you love and trust me, for I know you'll disgust me when you're old and getting fat. A lessened utility, a loss of mobility is a strong possibility. In all probability, I'll lose my virility and you your fertility and desirability. And this liability of total sterility will lead to hostility and a sense of futility. So let's act with agility while we still have facility, for we'll soon reach senility and lose the ability. Your teeth will start to go, dear. Your waist will start to spread. In 20 years or so, dear, I'll wish that you were dead. I'll never love you then at all the way I do today. So please remember when I leave in December, I told you so in May. trail, you'll find me loping. Why, the spaces are wide open in the land of the old AEC. Why, the scenery's attractive and the air is radioactive. Oh, the Wild West is where I want to be. Mid the sagebrush and the cactus, I'll watch the fellas practice dropping bombs through the clean desert breeze. I'll have on my sombrero, and of course I'll wear a pair of Levi's over my lead DVDs. I will leave the city's rush, leave the fancy and the plush, leave the snow and leave the slush and the crowds. I will seek the desert's hush, where the scenery is lush. How I long to see the mush room of clouds. Mid the yuccas and the thistles, I'll watch the guided missiles while the old FBI watches me. Yes, I'll soon make my appearance, soon as I can get my clearance, 'cause the Wild West is where I wanna be. Fight fiercely, Harvard, fight, 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 demonstrate to them our skill. Albeit they possess the might, nonetheless we have the will. How we shall celebrate our victory, we shall invite the whole team up for tea. How jolly, hurl that spheroid down in the field and fight, fight, fight. Fight fiercely, Harvard, fight, 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 impress them with our prowess, do. Oh, fellas, do not let the crimson down, be of stout heart and true. Come on, chaps, fight for Harvard's glorious name. Won't it be peachy if we win the game? Oh, goody, let's try not to injure them, but fight, fight, fight. Let's not be rough, though. Fight, 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 and do fight fiercely. Fight, fight, fight. Who made me the genius I am today? The mathematician that others all quote? Who's the professor that made me that way? The greatest that ever got chalk on his coat. One man deserves the credit, one man deserves the blame, and Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky is his name. Hi, Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky. I am never forget the day I first meet the great Lobachevsky. In one word, he told me secret of success in mathematics. Plagiarize. Plagiarize. Let no one else's work evade your eyes. Remember why the good Lord made your eyes. So don't shade your eyes, but plagiarize, plagiarize, plagiarize. Only be sure always to call it, please, research. And ever since I meet this man, my life is not the same. And Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky is his name. Hey, Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky. I am never forget the day I am given first original paper to write. It was on analytic and algebraic topology of local Euclidean metrization of infinitely differentiable Riemannian manifold. Boże moi. This I know from nothing. But I think of great Lobachevsky and I get idea. Ha ha! I have a friend in Minsk who has a friend in Pinsk, whose friend in Omsk has friend in Tomsk with friend in Akmolinsk. His friend in Alexandrovsk has friend in Petropavlovsk, whose friend somehow is solving now the problem in Dnipropetrovsk. And when his work is done, ha-ha, begins the fun. From Dnipropetrovsk to Petropavlovsk, by way of Yeisk and Novorossiysk, to Alexandrovsk, to Akmolinsk, to Tomsk, to Omsk, to Pinsk, to Minsk, to me the news will run. Yes, to me the news will run. And then I write by morning, night, and afternoon, and pretty soon my name in Dnipropetrovsk is cursed. When he finds out, I publish first. Ah, who made me a big success and brought me wealth and fame? Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky is his name. Hey, Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky. I am never forget the day my first book is published. Every chapter I stole from somewhere else. Index I copy from old Vladivostok telephone directory. This book was sensational. Pravda. Well, Pravda said Jill Bill Karoli Kagdat Prinyom Blacha Jila, it stinks. But Izvestia. Izvestia said, Ya idu kuda sam tsar idiot peshkom. It stinks. Metro Goldwyn Moskva buys movie rights for 6 million rubles, changing title to The Eternal Triangle, with Doris Day playing part of Hypotenuse. And who deserves the credit? And who deserves the blame? Nikolai Ivanovich Lobachevsky is his name. Hey! About a maid, I'll sing a song, sing rickety tickety tin. About a maid, I'll sing a song, who didn't have her family long. Not only did she do them wrong, she did every one of them in. She did every one of them in. One morning in a fit of pique, sing rickety tickety tin. One morning in a fit of pique, she drowned her father in the creek. The water tasted bad for a week, and we had to make do with gin, with gin. We had to make do with gin. Her mother, she could never stand, sing rickety tickety tin. Her mother, she could never stand, and so a cyanide soup she planned. The mother died with a spoon in her hand, and her face in a hideous grin, a grin. Her face in a hideous grin. She set her sister's hair on fire, sing rickety tickety tin. She set her sister's hair on fire, and as the smoke and flame rose higher, danced around the funeral pyre, playing a violin, olin, playing a violin. She weighted her brother down with stones, rickety tickety tin. She weighted her brother down with stones and sent him off to Davy Jones. All they ever found were some bones and occasional pieces of skin, of skin, occasional pieces of skin. One day when she had nothing to do, sing rickety tickety tin. One day when she had nothing to do, she cut her baby brother in two and served him up as an Irish stew and invited the neighbors in, bors in, invited the neighbors in. And when at last the police came by, sing rickety tickety tin. And when at last the police came by, her little pranks she did not deny. To do so she would have had to lie, and lying she knew was a sin, a sin. Lying she knew was a sin. My tragic tale I won't prolong, rickety tickety tin. My tragic tale I won't prolong, and if you do not enjoy my song, you've yourselves to blame if it's too long. You should never have let me begin, begin. You should never have let me begin. Was a year ago November, I went out to hunt some deer on a morning bright and clear. I went and shot the maximum the game laws would allow, 2 game wardens, 7 hunters, and a cow. I was in no mood to trifle. I took down my trusty rifle and went out to stalk my prey. What a haul I made that day. I tied them to my fender and I drove them home somehow. 2 game wardens, 7 hunters, and a cow. The law was very firm. It took away my permit, the worst punishment I ever endured. It took Turned out there was a reason. Cows were out of season, and one of the hunters wasn't insured. People ask me how I do it, and I say there's nothing to it. You just stand there looking cute, and when something moves, you shoot. And there's 10 stuffed heads in my trophy room right now. 2 game wardens, 7 hunters, and a purebred Guernsey cow. I really have a yen to go back once again. Back to the place where no one wears a frown. To see once more those super special, just plain folks in my hometown. No fella could ignore the little girl next door. She sure looked sweet in her first evening gown. Now there's a charge for what she used to give for free in my hometown. I remember Dan, the druggist on the corner. He was never mean or ornery, he was swell. He killed his mother-in-law and ground her up real well, and sprinkled just a bit over each banana split. The guy that taught us math, who never took a bath, acquired a certain measure of renown. And after school he sold the most amazing pictures in my hometown. That fellow was no fool who taught our Sunday school, and neither was our kindly Parson Brown. Shall I? No, I think I better not. In my hometown, I remember Sam. He was the village idiot, and though it seems a pity it was so, he loved to burn down houses just to watch the glow. And nothing could be done because he was the mayor's son. The guy that took a knife and monogrammed his wife, then dropped her in the pond and watched her drown. Oh yes, indeed, the people there are just plain folks in my home. Schnitzel waltz. The music was gay and the setting was Viennese. Your hair wore some roses, or perhaps they were peonies. I was blind to your obvious faults. As we danced across the scene to the strains of the Wiener Schnitzel waltz. Oh, I drank some champagne from your shoe. La la la, I was drunk by the time I got through. La la la, for I didn't know as I raised that cup, it had taken 2 bottles to fill the thing up. It was I who stepped on your dress. La la la, the skirts all came off, I confess. La la la, revealing for all of the others to see just what it was that endeared you to me. I remember the night I held you so tight as we danced to the Wiener Schnitzel waltz. Your lips were like wine, if you'll pardon the simile. The music was lovely and quite Rudolf Primly. I drank wine, you drank chocolate malts. And we both turned quite green to the strains of the Wiener Schnitzel waltz. my lips. I take a healthy bite from your dainty fingertips. My joy would be complete, dear, if you were only here. But still I keep your hand as a precious souvenir. The night you died, I cut it off. I really don't know why. For now, each time I kiss it, I get bloodstains on my tie. I'm sorry now I killed you, for our love was something fine. Until they come to get me, I shall hold your hand in mine. Be prepared. That's the Boy Scouts marching song. Be prepared. As through life you march along, be prepared to hold your liquor pretty well. Don't write naughty words on walls if you can't spell. Be prepared to hide that pack of cigarettes. Don't make book if you cannot cover bets. Keep that pot well hidden where you're sure that it will not be found. And be careful not to turn on when the scoutmaster's around, for he only will insist that it be shared. Be prepared. Be prepared. That's the Boy Scout's solemn creed. Be prepared. And be clean in word and deed. Don't solicit for your sister. That's not nice. Unless you get a good percentage of her price. Be prepared. And be careful not to do your good deeds when there's no one watching you. If you're looking for adventure of a new and different kind, and you come across a Girl Scout who is similarly inclined, don't be nervous, don't be flustered, don't be scared. Be prepared.